Oregon New York Giants player is about to get a beatdown after issuing nasty threat to fans. The National Football League is in trouble, and everybody knows it. The former fans know it, the owners know it, and Commissioner Goodall certainly knows it, which is why everyone with any monetary interest in the league is in panic mode. Not only are the teams and the league hemorrhaging money in the hundreds of millions, but the networks who carry the games are projecting a loss that totals around $500 million. One might think that results like that would cause everyone involved to tread very carefully and see what they could do to fix the problem. It seems that if a problem is only growing worse, one might want to pump the brakes on what got you there. But that's just not the method that the national anthem protesting players are taking in dealing with declining numbers of fans. They are ready to double down, seem to subscribe to the theory that they need to go big or go home. Well, they think that you can go home, anyway. In fact, that's exactly what New York Giants player Olivier Vernon told those who disagree with him, kneeling in disrespect to the American flag and those who fight to protect it. The New York Post reports that Vernon has only increased his antagonism as time goes on. After President Trump railed against the NFL protests taking place during the national anthem, instructing owners to deal with any player who took a knee to get that son of a bitch off the field right now, he's fired, three Giants players decided to kneel down prior to the Week 3 game in Philadelphia. Olivier Vernon, Landon Collins and Damon Snacks Harrison all took a knee during the national anthem, part of a widespread movement around the league. Since then, the protests have mostly dissipated. Vernon is the lone Giants player continuing to kneel during the national anthem, usually flanked by Collins and Harrison, who stand with their hands on Vernon's shoulder. Vernon told the Post on Thursday as he kneels, at home or on the road, he hears plenty of verbal abuse from fans. "You hear coward and stand up and disgrace," Vernon said. "It's fine. As long as nobody comes on the field and touches me. You stay where you at, you re going to be all right. They have a right. Oh yeah, I hear it all the time. If they don't like it, don't come to the game." That's right, apparently, Vernon and his friends are completely okay with playing to empty stadiums. "We were only there for decoration. It's curious to be able to observe just how out of touch with reality these players really are. It makes one wonder just where they think the money that they're being paid is coming from. It kind of makes you wonder if Vernon's bosses gave him the okay to send away the fans, because they certainly listened to him. Possibly, in the beginning, it seemed like there were enough fans to go around, and only a few would take that message to heart, but not now. At this point, it has become abundantly clear that there is not an unlimited amount of fans out there, and those who used to frequent the games are indeed staying home, and turning off the TV. But even this isn't enough for Vernon. This New York Giant thinks that the NFL's almost $100 million donation to charities that they thought might appease the social justice warrior players is just movement to a good direction. Vernon, born to a Jamaican father, a recently retired Miami police officer of 25 years and Swiss mother, said he was heartened to hear the news this week that the NFL and its teams will donate about $90 million by 2023 to social causes deemed important by the players, focusing on African American communities. "Making progress, moving forward," Vernon said. "I don't know all the logistics of everything right now, but it sounds like it has great movement to a good direction." This direction, he said, is why he kneels during the national anthem and why he will continue to do so for the remainder of the season. Vernon has always maintained his actions are about highlighting racial injustice and not about disrespect for the flag or country. "I am fine where I am at right now. Ain't nothing wrong with feeling bad for what you believe in. What's right is right and what's wrong is wrong. I stand behind my beliefs. If that says what I think it says, then Vernon and I finally agree on something. What's right is right, and giving honor to whom honor is due is the right thing to do. That's why when the NFL is on, I want to be watching, and when the anthem is played, I will be standing.